What an extraordinary tournament we just witnessed here, Brandon. Another buzzer beater by the tournament player of this time, Arike Ogunbowale. What did you think of this whole tournament?
Arike Ogunbowale is incredible. This tournament, well, this Final Four did a lot for the state of women's college basketball. I think it's going to put them more on the map, going to lessen their detractors. This is possibly the best Final Four, regardless of gender, that we've ever seen. The first two games went to overtime. This one ended on a undeniable buzzer beater by Arike, pretty much right here behind where we're standing. It's just a great weekend for college basketball.
So now the story here is the junior guard, Arike Ogunbowale, who hit two buzzer beaters to take Notre Dame into this championship game and now to their second title. Absolutely amazing that Notre Dame was able to do this. Earlier in the year, they lost four players to ACL injuries, and yet they managed to be here this weekend. Brandon, we talked a lot about UConn, how they have not been able to find those shots, find an Arike Ogunbowale in that position to hit that clutch shot in the last seconds of a game. Is that a problem? What are we going to do next year?
Well, it's only a problem when UConn finds themselves in those situations. A lot of the time, UConn's beating teams by a lot of points, and they've shown that they can hit shots in the big moment, but it's not shots like that. Arike Ogunbowale hit a step back over Nafisa Collier on Friday. Then she hit a shot that when I saw her get it off,
it
I thought
contested.
There was thought there was no shot that was going in. It's a little bit different than Kia Nurse's breakaway layup, which was an incredible play, and the same with Crystal Dangerfield's three-pointer to tie it in overtime on Friday. Those are huge shots, but they're not shots that they really can create on their own in an isolation situation. I think UConn could really use a player like that. Could be Katie Lou Samuelson as she continues to expand her game and heads into her senior year next season. Don't know what Kristen Williams and Olivia Nelson Odota are going to bring to the table. Don't know what kind of steps forward Megan Walker could take, Crystal Dangerfield. I think they will find a player that can do something like that, but as of this season, they didn't have it, and that may have been what hurt them down the stretch.
Now, we talked about UConn losing two semifinals two straight years. Mississippi State just lost their second straight championship game, which is heartbreaking. They are losing most of their team, except for Tara McCohen. Mm-hmm. Now, for UConn, the good news is that besides Gavi and Kia, which we have to recognize that they're amazing players and undoubtedly the leaders of this team, but most of their team players are coming back. Their bench players, Katie Lou Samuelson, Nafisa Collier, Crystal Dangerfield, mm-hmm. with another year and another Final Four she didn't play last year. So it is fair to say that we will have, or UConn will have, the advantage in having returning players with experience. Tell me, what do you see for this team next year? Are they going to go undefeated again? What's going to happen?
Undefeated, I think, will be difficult, as it is in any season. It will, I think, largely depend on the freshman class coming in. Mm-hmm. It's a little tough to say, but if these incoming freshmen have an impact of, say, what Megan Walker had this year, which was, you know, minimal, I don't think they'll go undefeated. But if Megan Walker takes a step forward, and if those freshmen produce, and if Katie Lou Samuelson, Nafisa Collier, Crystal Dangerfield, Azaree Stevens do what we know they can do, they can approach an undefeated season. But again, they don't need to go undefeated to win a national championship. I think they're in a great spot to potentially compete for one. Notre Dame is going to be a huge threat next year. Again, they're returning almost everybody everyone who was a key contributor other than Catherine Westbell. She's graduating. I think UConn is in one of the better spots as far as the top teams having returning players. So they'll be in good shape next year. You know, hope isn't lost.
I gotcha. Now, we talked about the freshmen. We talked about what Olivia and Kristen Williams can bring to the game. But Gino has complained a lot about him not being able to get into the players the way that he was used to before. And that's kind of worrisome for UConn fans that the magic might be gone for you. I mean, obviously it's not gone because he still has amazing players, but if those players, like this year we talked a lot about their freshmen not being able to contribute as they should, they were a highly recruited class. So what are your thoughts on that?
I think next season will be very telling as far as that goes. Megan Walker, again, it's going to sound like I'm trash talking Megan Walker. She's going to be a great player at UConn. Mm-hmm. She just didn't have the impact you would expect from a number one recruit. And next season, we'll find out if lack of impact from top recruits is a Geno problem or if it was just a fluke thing, if, you know, Megan had a tough time adjusting. We'll see. Gino, I don't think you can really make the argument that he can't get through to the players. Maybe he had a harder time just based on certain player personalities. You know, we don't know everything that goes on in closed practices and stuff like that. I think you have to reserve judgment on that until after next season, potentially the season after. But at the end of the day, UConn is pretty likely to be back here, you know, at least in the Final Four. So any reaction to Gino being unable to get through to players, I think just has to be tabled for now.
Absolutely. Now, this was the first Final Four for players like Azure Stevens, Crystal Dangerfield. That might have played a role, but we certainly hope and think that UConn will be able to put themselves in this position again in Tampa. Do you have anything else to add before we sign off from Nationwide Arena?
Not much. Just thank you to Gabby Williams and Kia Nurse. You've been a pleasure to cover for us from UCTV Sports. We talked to Kia Nurse after they lost on Friday. Obviously a tough moment, and she was just incredibly courteous to us, as she has been all season, all career. Her and Gabby are going to be missed. They're going to be great ambassadors for the team going forward. And it's just, you know, enough can't be said about their impact on the team.
Well, I am really happy how, not happy because UConn lost, but obviously this was a great tournament to witness in person, unlike anything that I ever seen before. Great games, great players, and at the end, I think women's basketball and basketball in general just won this weekend. So for Brandon Carney, I'm Daniela Marulanda, and we are signing